180!
Right, Phil, we're finally in Sydney. The last stop of the Masters Tour here. We've had Singapore, we've had Perth, now we're in Sydney. I must admit, after Perth, bubbly, a great win in Perth. And yes. You're looking pretty lively here as well.
I'm all right, I feel good. I'm waking up at night, I'm not sleeping during the night, so I'm wide awake, which is good for me. I just said to Bob, I think I'd rather have it this way. So at least at night time, then I'm ready for go. So I won't be playing till about 11 o'clock at night, maybe half 11, which is quite late, so I'm quite pleased about it.
Well, Singapore was a little bit indifferent for your state. At Perth, you put it right. I mean, the semi-finals and final. Of course, you've got to mention beating Michael in the final, which you quite enjoyed, beating the world number one. He's got your spot there.
Uh-huh.
I mean, that 17th leg, you know, he didn't hit anything, but you won that. And then the 1-2 final after that.
I think that was the finish for me, yeah. That, I remember looking at it thinking, just finish this. And that puts you, I don't know, one or two legs off. That was the turning point for me. That gave me the confidence to go and win it. Then with the shots, the turning games.
Well, everybody's seen your form over the last year. It's been a bit up and down. You know, 54 years old now. I mean, been in this game 30 years.
Yeah.
What is the motivation that keeps you going?
You don't let me have a day off. You. I enjoy it. I mean, I have set me records straight. You know that I want to get ready when I'm about 55, 56. So Barry's asked me. I think I'm 57 when I retire. So I can look forward and work hard now till I'm 57, and just try and keep setting records. And I don't like to get beat either. I like winning. So,
really? Yeah. Never noticed that at all.
I hate getting beat. So plus it's the new players coming through. You know, they have that little bit of edge on and a little bit of cockiness, which I like, and you know, Michael's got it, just walk past. I quite like it, and I know he hasn't got a bad bone in his body, but he's a ruthless boy when he's up on the stand, so fair play to him. So that's what makes me get up in the morning and think, well, I'm going to practice today.
So, lifting the Sydney Masters title along with the Perth Masters would be a nice little double to travel back home.
I would love it, yeah. Plus I think, you know, you know as I know, you've got other people to think about as well. You know, you've got family, you've got your grandchildren, I've got the sponsors to think about, like Target and whatnot. You know, they've got to sell their product, so you've got to go out there and perform for them as well. So that I've always been, with being sponsored with Eric, he always drilled that in me. That's when I owed him money. So he did, he set something to me. My mother was the same. You know, you work on a factory, that factory's got to pay your wages, that factory's got to earn money, get your work done. So that's what I've always had drilled into.
Well, cheers, Phil. I'm sure that Phil will be one of the favourites, if not the hottest favourite, coming into the Sydney Masters, and certainly I'm looking forward to it.
Joint favourite.
You'll probably think it's the favourite.
For more interviews, more darts, click on this button.